several years ago, I was involved in the online literary community. I wrote a lot of poetry, a lot of short stories, and I was on the staff of several online literary magazines. And I realized that there weren't any publications for disabled people specifically. There were magazines for people of color and queer people, but nothing for people with disabilities, and specifically nothing for women with disabilities. So I thought, why not start my own? I really had no idea of what to do going forward, but I just kind of put out a call on social media, just asking if anyone would be interested, and I was just shocked by how many people offered their time and their skills and even just their money to help me build a community. So in 2016, I founded Monstering, a magazine for disabled women and non-binary people. I am still on the board of the magazine as the founder, but I stepped down in 2018 as the editor-in-chief. I have a lot going on. I just started graduate school, so I didn't want to take on too much, but I really have so much love for Monstering and what it has become. It's really difficult to kind of put yourself out there and form your own community. But if you can find people that are interested and people that need that community as much as you do, it becomes a lot easier to kind of figure out the specifics and really just put yourself out there. It's a lot of energy, it's a lot of work, but if you have a mission in mind and if you know why you're doing it, it becomes so much easier. It becomes really fun. So if you're interested in forming your own community, I would suggest first and foremost to find the people that want the same thing you do, because inevitably there are going to be hard times and you're just not going to want to do anything, but those people are going to come up beside you and lift you up and give you the support that you need to change the world.